Welcome to Midnight Madness! My name is Peter Kaplowski. This is the Toronto International Film Festival. This is Midnight Madness, and you're about to watch Shadow in the Cloud! I like this. I like the honk applause. This is pretty great. All right, everybody. This is a thrill. I've always wanted to do a Midnight Madness field trip. I'm so excited to be here. And for those at the back, totally made it on the first time. Totally made it on the first time, the hat stand trick. It's landed, it's great. It was not a metaphor for 2020 whatsoever. To begin, let's acknowledge we're outside, we're on land. Let's acknowledge the land we're on. The treaty territory, the Mississaugas of the Credit, the traditional territory of the Haudenosaunee, the Anishinaabe, and the Wendat. And we are gosh darn grateful. Honk for that, please, come on. And continue to honk for our major sponsor, Bell, L'Oreal, lead sponsor, RBC, L'Oreal, and of course, Visa for this amazing Skyline Visa drive-in at Cityview. I particularly love the time tunnel that they installed. I hope that's a permanent fixture. A big thank you, of course, to the government of Ontario, the city of Toronto, all of our members and donors, and something I especially want to highlight this year. Thank you to the volunteers that can't work for us this year, but that support us every year. A huge round of honks for the volunteers. And I gotta say, I gotta warn everybody because we weren't able to facilitate having volunteers this year, but there was one who showed up, and he was very insistent. And he said he was related to something in the movie. And so if you see a volunteer roaming around, they'll have the orange shirt. They're supposed to be there. I just didn't want to mess with it. It just seemed like it just wanted to help out. So we're letting that happen. So just in case you see someone roaming around in an orange shirt, it's fine. It's meant to be there. Finally, I got a lot of things to say. There's something that I'm pretty excited about this year, even though we have a limited slate, it's less Midnight Madness films than you're used to. The People's Choice Award is anyone's game. It could go to a Midnight Madness film this year. I feel like nobody thought of that when they were figuring out the rules, like, wait, a Midnight Madness film could get the People's Choice Award. So tiff.net/vote and Shadow in the Cloud or Get the Hell Out or Violation could upset everything. And Variety and Hollywood Reporter probably already have their mastheads picked out, and suddenly this Midnight Madness film will swoop in, so do not forget to vote at tiff.net/vote. And a big thank you to Endeavor Content and New Zealand Film Commission for providing us with this film. And also, the film is also eligible for the Amplify Artist Awards, supported by Canada Goose, so thank you for that. Now, finally, the movie you're about to see. I am so thrilled that we're gonna be watching this movie like the character in this film experiences, confined to a metal vehicle. Near an airport, perhaps airplanes will careen overhead as they do in the film. There will be weird things roaming around the area. Much of the audio in this film is communicated through radio transmission, and that transmission is coming straight to through your car radios as well. But more than anything, I think Roseanne Liang is going to be a major, major talent. I've been a fan of her for years. The first thing I ask you to do when you get home, apart from voting and tweeting about this movie, is to check out Do No Harm, her short film on Vimeo. It's exceptional, and if this film doesn't convince you, that will. She's one of the major action filmmakers working today. And if I can leave you with two themes that I think this movie absolutely distills incredibly well: believe women and hold motherfucking monsters accountable!